Hello, I'm Maria Pia D'Arienzo from the University of Salerno, and I'm here to present the work written together with Professors Diana Conte, Beatrice Paternoster, and Raffaele D'Ambrosio about single diagonal implicit multivalue collocation methods. In particular, the aim of the work is to find the method for a solution of initial values problems, such as ordinary differential equations. The ordinary differential equation can model a lot of phenomena, especially in biology, so it's very interesting to find method for their solution. In addition, we can observe that if we have a partial differential equation, we can solve them using a through the method of lines by the semi-discretization of the space, and we will obtain a system of ordinary differential equation, which is famous to be stiff. So the method that we use must be suitable for stiff problem that we want to develop must be suitable for stiff problems. So they need to have uniform order on convergence on the whole integration interval, they will have high stability properties, and we would like to reduce the computational effort. Decide to use multivalue methods, which are a general class of methods for resolution of ordinary differential equation, which are a generalization of the classical methods for them, such as multivalue method, multi-step methods, and Runge-Gutta methods. The methods on a uniform grid, considering C, the abscissa vector, take this form. We can observe that capital Y are the internal stages and represent the approximation of the solution in some points, which depends on the interval in which we are, and from the collocation, the abscissa, the points. Also, that depends on two matrices, A and U, which define the method. And all in addition, we have external stages, which depends on matrices B and V, and which are in the Nordic form, so they are the derivative of the solution from derivative 0 to R minus 1. We want to extend this method to collocation. Collocation is a technique widely used in literature, and it consists in the approximation of the solution by a piecewise collocation polynomial. Collocation applied to multivalue methods permits to extend the solution smoothly. In particular, the collocation polynomial depends on two types of functions, alpha I and beta I, which depends on which are the functional basis of the polynomial and are algebraic polynomial. In order to have collocation, this polynomial must satisfy interpolation condition and collocation condition, which are the following one. Using collocation to the method to multivalue method, the matrix A, U, B, and B take this particular form. So they depends on the functional basis of the polynomial, so beta and alpha. We are interested in particular on the matrix A. In fact, if we look in the formulation of the method, the computational cost of the method is strictly connected to the matrix, to the structure of the matrix A. In fact, if A is a full matrix, the method is fully implicit because it's necessary to solve non-linear system a full non-linear system. So we want to change the structure of the matrix A in order to have to reduce the computational effort and not solve all the whole the system, a full system, but maybe a reduced one. Of course, we need some order conditions, and we have this theorem, which assures that if the polynomials alpha and beta satisfies this condition, we have a method of order p. And this condition have been obtained by the Taylor expansion of the solution of the error. In addition, we know that we can obtain in a stable method if the constraints are smaller or equal to m plus 1 is fulfilled. Well, we remember r is the number of external stages while m is the number of internal ones. Also, in addition, we know that the maximum uniform order that we can obtain in order for a method to be stable is 2m. And we can also rewrite the condition of the previous theorem in a discrete form in which we have the functional basis alpha and beta in sum in zero and inside the collocation point. So the we want to write develop a method with a triangular matrix A. Which are the pros and which the cons? Of course, the matrix A, lower triangular matrix A, permits to solve the internal stages equation in n successive steps with only a k-dimensional system to be solved at each step, where k is the dimensional of the initial value problem. So, of course, the computational effort is reduced. But in addition, if we have one-point spectrum, so it means that the elements on the diagonal are all the same, we can also store LU factorization of the Jacobian when we solve the system using Newton type iteration. So we can further reduce the computational cost. Of course, the imposing of this condition reduce the number of coefficients of the functional beta and alpha. So we cannot impose all collocation and interpolation condition. That's why we don't speak about collocation, but we speak about almost collocation, because no collocation condition are not all fulfilled. In addition, we have to give to some order, we give up to some order condition, because since we have less coefficient, we cannot impose all of them, so we have an order smaller than 2m. Let's see in detail which is the structure of the matrix A. In particular, if we want the matrix A to be lower triangular, this means that all the elements above the diagonal should be zero. If in addition we want to be singly lower triangular, we have to impose that the coefficient on the diagonal are the same. So the functional beta can be written in the following form in order to have this condition to be fulfilled. And it depends on another polynomial, omega, which is of degree r minus m plus 1, and which it depends on this coefficient mu k. So the aim in order to construct this method is to find this coefficient. If we look to condition given by the theorem, we can see that from condition 5 we can compute the functional alpha, the polynomial alpha from the polynomials beta. So we are sure that we will have order r minus 1 at least. But in addition, we can impose some of them of the condition 6 in order to have a big order. Now I present some examples of a method with 2 internal stages and 3 external stages. This is with the triangular coefficient matrix, so the elements on the diagonal are not the same. If the matrices have this form, which are represented in the Butcher tableau, And they have this form when the coefficient of these polynomials have been determined, as I said previously, by imposing all the condition five. So the alpha are computed by them, and by imposing some of the condition six, in particular just for r, for mu equal r, for ni equal r. The other ones, coefficients, have been chosen in order for the method to be stable by performing the Schur criterion, which permits to find the values of the abscissa coefficients C1 and C2 in order to obtain a stability. I did the same for the method in which, in this case, we have a singly triangular matrix. The coefficient on the diagonal are the same, and the functional takes this form. In this picture, we can observe the region of a stability in the C1, C2 plane obtained by the performing of the Schur analysis. So, of course, we can see that the additional request of having the same element of the diagonal have reduced the region of a stability, but we obtain a lower cost, a lower computational cost. As example, we choose this coefficient, these collocation points, and we obtain the following methods. This is the case when the matrix is just a lower triangular, while in this case we have a singly lower triangular matrix. For both, we have chosen the same value of the vector C. And we now want to test these two problems, so these two methods with these values for the coefficients, on a test problem in order to verify experimentally the order of the method, because theoretically we have that these methods have order 3. In fact, as I said previous, we have imposed all the condition 5 and just the condition 6 just for the value of ni equals to r. So considering that r is equal to 3, we have order 3. We can apply both those methods to the Protero-Robinson problems, which is stiff when lambda is very small. And we compare the results obtained with the Gaussian-Runge-Kutta method, which is famous to suffer from order reduction. In fact, we can see that when lambda is minus 10 to 6, so it's very small and the problem is stiff, both methods introduced have a bigger numerical order, or a numerical order bigger than the one that we have theoretically expected, while Runge-Kutta methods have an order reduction. In fact, Runge-Kutta method has theoretical order 4, but uniform order 2. In fact, that's what we obtain. And we can also compare GLMT and GLMS, and we observe that the results are comparable. So this means that even if imposing the additional requirements that method cannot have, that method have the same element on the diagonal, the performances are good, the same, still good. So it's convenient to use that in order to reduce the computational effort. So we have proved that the introduced methods have uniform of convergence and they don't suffer of order reduction, and that we have experimentally confirmed the theoretical order. future work will address the construction of methods with the diagonal coefficient matrix. In fact, if the coefficient matrix is diagonal, we can also parallelize the methods and solve the system in parallel. And then also we can apply the same technique to different kinds of methods, such as partial differential equation, oscillatory problems, integral differential equation, fractional and stochastic equation. These are some references have been used for this paper. And thanks for the attention.